synergies between the two areas and kind of see their heritage. It was a really, really, really quite incredible piece. And then we moved swiftly on to the tour series in Hamilton Square. And obviously I mentioned later we've got the tour at Britain Stage coming to Borough later in the year. This again showcased Hamilton Square, beautiful day, fantastic crowd, again 10,000 people came to see this, and it was just a really, really about actually how can we build theatre companies, how can we build all of that sort of practitioners living in Borough, can we make a living out of arts and culture. Far is the public health annual report, which this year will be focused on culture and its impact on wellbeing. So lots of things happening there which will be more in the future strategy as well. Final slide really on what we hope to achieve for Borough Culture in terms of that legacy. So we want to have that established reputation for delivering ambition and excellence. We want to increase that engagement. So we're proving we're doing that through our evaluation committee, we focus on capturing that information. Focus on children and young people. We put in place a local creative education partnership which brings together schools and other partners to ensure access to arts and culture, but also to think about creative curriculum planning. Increased opportunities for local artists to participate and to be involved. Strengthen partnerships, change perceptions of place, really important one. And you'll see that idea of those images being part of actually where we live and increasing pride. We are showcasing our tourism offer, boosting the local economy, we'll have an increased track record for future investments and commercial opportunities, and that will lead to our growth and regeneration plans. And we're aligning with those national and international strategies to ensure we can support the culture programming moving forward and that wider agenda.
Very impressed by all the events that have taken place and look forward to the ones that are coming forward. Any questions or comments? Yes, Stephen first.
Yeah, a couple of comments. First of all, congratulations to the team. And first of all, just saying, you don't actually need the title of Winner of Culture 2019. It was an impetus and there was some funding associated with it. But if you look back to 18, what was building up to it and what is the future, I think we're in a good place in terms of building our visitor economy and satisfying the cultural needs of our own people as well. Obviously, as a councillor, Bergman Park falls within my ward and George's and others. The only thing I would say, just not criticism, but in the build-up to some of these events, I think there needs to be some pre-publicity with the most immediate favours, because we got the witching hour was an extremely exciting thing. But they had a dress rehearsal the night before, no one knew it was taking place. So my phone was very hard to think of, you know, Brian was Martians and landed or whatever. So it was a little bit, but that is, you know, in the scale of things. The comment I got back from people was, yeah, we want the park to be used, we want it to be full of people, we're excited about it, but just let us know a little bit more in advance of what's going on. The other thing I want to sort of see is the sort of legacy thing that's going on, and a lot of people have seen Hammock Square probably for the first time. A lot of people have seen other parts of the park and whatever for the first time. It needs to be stuff for them to go back to, you know, in the future. Not just events, but the actual offer that's there. I just want to finish off on this because I've been sort of out and about the last couple of weekends and I'm greatly impressed with what's happened down at Woodside. If anyone's been to the Woodside Ferry Village, you know, there's a real offer on there now. You link that to the trams that, you know, we invested in heavily many years ago running. We've got the driving cinema down at Woodside and that then interconnects with Albert Square, so there's a week. There's got to be a reason for you to go there. You can't just go, and, you know, because people want to have lunch and what have you. So there needs to be a bit like New Brighton, there needs to be a critical mass of places for you to go. A bit like, you know, Royal Lake, West Kirby, you've got sort of a little critical mass that can attract people and beautiful beaches and that sort of thing. The other things that I want to see are projects coming off of this and sustainable projects that keep people coming back on a regular basis. So I think, you know, it is great news and you can see what it's doing for the economy and what, you know, reiterate our thanks to the team and it's something that we vitally need. And the things I have been to see, I have seen them out of buying and just remind me of go and see that way that there is and stuff. So there's still lots to do and see, so please all walk and people in and around the immediate vicinity of events will be great stuff. Thank you very much.
Next year, Steve, so much for it as well. Thank you. Yeah, it is refreshing because we often sit here and others do, but we're happy years, and it's just great to see what's happened London in a small amount of time. I did see Facebook the night before the park, and as you say, there was people did think at the end of the world was coming. But just getting that out. One of the good things is the volunteering that you touched on, volunteering social value that's having, particularly with all the volunteers, and hopefully that will help because obviously we do know we have got a big problem with social isolation. So that's helping as well. So yeah, just to thank yourself and Lucy and the team for all that's gone well. Thank you.
Thank you.
I know we sit back here quite often going on about the negative, but I really have to highlight the positives here. It's just been absolutely wonderful. And actually, I think to myself, what actually started the heritage Easter attention, it was that plaque scheme starting from Eastern 10, 12 years ago, where all the local heritage groups got together and put all the history inputs for interpretation plaques going from here to New Brighton and further. And since then, there's been, as you know, HMS Burke and Health and Thesis, the whole number of other historical plaques and plinths going right down the Mersey. But then we've got the blue plaque scheme coming in through conservation areas as well. And I will say, of course, the heritage history was very well organised on it, because we saw, well, maybe you've heard all this before, we saw years ago the only way heritage could move forward was bringing all the heritage groups together, forming a partnership with the council, the number 60 heritage groups, and what a wonderful, it's been copied now by other councils. Our heritage strategy was copied, our heritage open days, which is second to none. There's just so much good going on through all the people. But also, let me say, at one stage, culture was behind because we didn't have a culture strategy. So then the culture strategy clicked in, and then we've had all the wonderful work that's been done by officers, by a cabinet member, and I also got to thank Arlene Wilshaw, who has got a 30-year speciality of heritage, not only on the Wirral or Liverpool and Chester, and she knows how to access heritage lottery funding, and so that has been a wonderful thing. And also, I think it's wonderful things we've done with the armed forces from a heritage point of view. It's been absolutely spectacular, and it's still going on. And of course, the programme for culture this year is still being put together. I mean, we're having probably about a high percentage of the Peruvian Navy turning up in that downtown and plus the ambassador in December. And it's because of Wirral's global connections that it makes it so easy for us to connect from a international standpoint. So again, I just want to compliment all the wonderful work that's been done. I mean, one of the key issues from the Wirral standpoint has been, and I mentioned this before, you've got all these people going on to the cruise ships, and there's been sort of a closed shop going on there from the point of view of the tour guides, which I don't think Wirral has done Wirral favours. We've highlighted this on a whole number of occasions. And because you've got people like these blue badge guides, blue badge guides are only interested in blue badge guides. They're not interested from the point of view of promoting heritage on Merseyside from an inclusive standpoint. And that's been one of the main problems that we've had. But again, just to say, and conservation areas will be absolutely, again, winning awards, just we're really excelling in every area. And I think all of us on the council should be really proud of the work that's being done, and to compliment the staff, our cabinet members, everyone that's been involved. I'll always say heritage first, not culture, because you know what I'm like. But it's been an absolute wonderful partnership, and I just congratulate everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. Yes, Tony.
those big events we work through the Local Enterprise Partnership Commission artwork, and so they gather that data. And so a lot of that is survey based in terms of where businesses have come from, their spend for the day. And so there's a sample taken of visitors, and then there's calculations in that. So and that is obviously that's kind of industry best practice in the way that they do that, and a recognised formula to doing that. I think so there is a quantifiable methodology, and I'm more than happy to send you some information on that so you can see how that is calculated. Where that's done in that way, so it's sometimes harder to do for, I would say, maybe smaller events or where there are slightly different events. And in terms of the calculations around that economic impact, they are based on that quantifiable approach. But we also think it's really important to gather the impacts, and some of that is possibly more case study or quantitative. So I'll give an example which wouldn't be necessarily caught up in that economic impact, but to me really tells the story of it. Is that I don't know if you know a vegan restaurant in Hamilton Square called Joro, which has got opened quite recently, I think, and is super cafe restaurant. They opened specially for Animated Square, which was opened later, and lots of people popped in, and they wrote to us specifically to say the impact of that has been really good because people have come back again and again following kind of popping in for a coffee. Now, whether they are people that live in that area or passing through, I think that to me is an illustrative example of it's hard, it is a big claim to make, but actually it's those things that kind of build that momentum that starts to make a real impact on local businesses and community and starts to bring forward that overall change. But I absolutely can share that methodology because I think if you're interested in that, you can see how all of that's calculated. But it's on a questionnaire survey sample basis that there's formula calculated.
Thanks, Chair. We're seeing an increase in volunteers, which is fantastic. As they are representing, we're all in one form or other. Are the checks carried out from them? What checks are carried out from them to ensure that the right people are volunteering is one of my concerns. So that's number one.
In terms of how volunteers are managed during events, there is a clear kind of, we always have a volunteer manager, for example, in place to support volunteers, the first thing I would say. Like for all volunteers that work with the council, it does depend on the nature of what you're doing. So we wouldn't necessarily ask for unless it was a specific project where there was vulnerable people might be involved and that was required. The general event, we wouldn't do that because it's clear briefings and that's a clause in place and people are bodied up. But is that to answer your question or is it about, because there's an application process that people fill in a form, say, well, give some details, why they want to volunteer, and then we will give them an induction and kind of support them through the events.
Yeah, that's great. It's just, I think, my concern is on the safeguarding issue.
Yes,
and if we are having a lot of volunteers, it's not only safeguarding, it's also safeguarding the local name as well.
No, yeah.
So that was a concern we've got. Now, the other concerns we've already raised with you about which now,
yes,
we'll carry about
that.
Thank you.
You've got
that.
Can I just say, I'm not being selective in, I try and pick people to put them in. I just was looking in your direction and so was looking for us. Okay? So, just relax, Jerry.
Thank you, Chair. What are you for more figures? Jay, just got the last question, probably equally as old as the previous one, to be fair. So, with regards to financial return, whilst it's still a little bit, we can't be 100% accurate on that, I don't think, on what the actual return is, but it's kind of a forecast, and it's going to be always going to be a ballpark, I think, on what we've actually generated. Whilst, it can't be 100% accurate, but the even more, or the even less objective one, I would say, I'll just read
some of the others not so. You could argue that if the overall rates comes here, people are going to take up cycling, maybe. How do we go about actually digging into the data in that and ensure that we don't come up with the wrong outcomes and the wrong picture of what it's actually generated?
Again, really good question. Obviously that's hard to quantify, and I know having worked in kind of policy and strategy for a long time in terms of interventions, how we actually determine what those outcomes are when it's not direct, you know, it's not outputs, it's not kind of numbers of participants, it's about the quality of some of the experience, whether that, you know, frankly has transformed their aspirations or their focus. I think we're on a journey most of that, and I think very, very strong focus on both the quantitative and qualitative data in terms of assessing events. So alongside those more kind of detailed surveys, we've got postcards which we capture people's kind of feedback on that. I think collectively that does give a sense of the social impact, whether that is civic pride or whether it's how that's made people feel, or they feel much more part of the community, and that's definitely a thread that's come through. Again, I accept the point that that's not necessarily quantitative. You know, we can't say that for all 80,000 people who came to Giants, but there's a thread there. And again, this idea of case studies and understanding, kind of seeing projects through from start to finish in terms of where people participate in, I think is a really important bit of that evidence. We do want to build that evidence base, and one of the things that the Arts Council will be working with them on is kind of audience development plan. And that goes much more in detail way about who will be kind of wanting to work with to do all of those kind of transformational projects, and that's very much a thread of how they want to evaluate and monitor what we're doing. So I'd say that is a bit of a journey, but I think there's a lot of evidence internationally and nationally around the impact of cultural well-being, and there's a lot of that, for example, Arts Council's also around that. And I think it's about drawing that together and understanding how that is applies to rural. So again, we'll seek to do more of that as we continue on this journey. But in terms of that, there is a weight of evidence that if you participate in an arts and cultural activity, you will feel less isolated, you will feel better, that may take you on a path to better outcomes. But again, it's how will we evaluate that in rural. We know that is the case, and we know that the people will be benefiting, but we will always continue to do more to
Chair, if I can just one second, I'll be very quick. Yeah, obviously I want there to be a legacy and I want it to be successful. What I would say, I don't want us to over-evaluate what we think we'll get out of it. An example would be the Olympics, as a prime example. That they thought everyone was going to run out and start taking up sports, and the reality is they didn't. So we need to make sure that we are actually realistic about what we're getting from it.
The economic impact and social value. There's a number of strands, and I think it's making the business case at the end of the day stand up to say this is a good thing that we're doing, it's having a whole impact on us all those areas.
Just before I bring the UK, I just want to make one comment today. And it's a proven fact, and we do know that the our groups within the world are actually growing at the present time, and it does have a major effect. Anybody steal it? Geoffrey will be able to say, once you're the mayor, you start going around the peninsula and see what's going on. It really is an eye-opener. The answer to wonderful stuff that's being done. Airbnb is one that's stuck in my mind, because I was looking at paintings that were done of bamboos and birch trees, and they were like photographs. They were absolutely amazing. And the gentleman did it, was a little doctor who just in his spare time take up painting to relax. Right, it's a major effect on that. Jerry?
Yeah, thanks. Just a few final points. If this is not us doing things right, I don't know what is. Here we are, we've lost two-thirds of our budget, we all know, over the last 10 years, and the officers and the councillors and the whole organisation is going out and bringing in funding from outside, outside parties. This is exactly what we've got to do. And then, a lot, for instance, like the Hoy Lake History Society, what absolutely amazing organisation. I've known them for many, many years. I've been elected to them. Everywhere around the world, we've got these amazing groups, and it's the professionalism of them. We talk about volunteers. The volunteer setup has been absolutely second to none. I mean, you've got people like Joy Hockey, Elizabeth Davy. David Armstrong, just look at me now, and you know, the specialities that these people have, and how this really enriches our society. It's an enriched world because they have an enthusiasm, infectious enthusiasm, that can just knock down walls, it can do anything. And so, as I said, we've got a very, very positive thing. All the organisational things are very important. So really take on board some of the comments made there. But I think the work that's going on in the background there, the volunteers, the outreach, it's just tremendous. And you find the times we've got plenty of things to criticise about the council, but this is not one of them. I just want to congratulate everyone for the work they do. Thank you.
Let's just say that Councillor Cox and I agree on pretty much everything in life, I think. Although he's a little bit more than me.
Sorry, you finished
the game. But I think we do disagree on arts and culture, and arts and culture placemaking, just carry on, don't sweat the project. Don't worry about it.
Just a quick one, David. I've been to everyone. Wish you up there. I've had the pleasure of going along to every single one of them. And it's been a highlight of the year, especially. And to see the crowds that have turned out, not just from the world, people all around who have come to these things. It's something that I've wanted to see for a long, long time happening in the world. Got lovely rivers outside of us, and we should use them and utilise them to the best way we can, which we do. And we've also got, I've just been watching the ladies play football in the World Cup, and you think, out of them, nine of them are from Merseyside and play for the Travel
Corps.
So the whole thing is, whenever you put something back into it, and you're actually right to question the point I fully understand there. But what was it be like? I was just coming back up to Premier League to League One. Straight away, the crowds increase and the turnover increases. So there's a lot of people when you say, I want to stay over the night, but we haven't had hotels. We need other hotels in the world. I'll always remember Andy Williams going back to 1990, and he called this Will the Leisure Peninsula, and that's what we need to ask and grasp it. And I think what the team are doing at the moment is exactly that. They're selling Will out there, and in a very, very positive manner. And as you quite rightly said, the one in Bedford Park, I was just absolutely amazed, just that dynamic. I've never seen anything like it in my life. How many people never got hurt watching my head? I'll tell you, I've never seen anything like it. But it was absolutely fabulous, walking in between everything else. But that was all done by the volunteers who were guiding you and me. Pitch black. Here we are, in the middle of the bar, anyone could go on, couldn't it? And nothing did go on for the which is what I never did. But the whole thing was an amazing thing. I think, well, I'd like to complete my statement saying congratulations to Lucy, Jane, and the full team, because the way it's gone into it has been significant, very significant. And what the challenge is going to be when we're not need to be thinking now of 2021, 2022, 2023, and make sure that we, through City of Reason, everything else, we get our fair share of it, and make sure that we can still put on these significant things all the way through. Thank you.
Sure. Yeah,
okay.
Just a very quick word, Chair, just to help with my appreciation to Lucy and Jane and the team for your thank you, and I think it's nice to get that thanks. I would just add to that my appreciation to all the other staff who helped with this. Clearly, all these spaces have to be prepared. Yes. I think my road closures, preparing the park to take more people, cleaning them afterwards, providing all the additional accommodation for people. So there's a whole lot of other staff put their time into this, often over and above the job they were doing before. And also, a significant number of staff volunteered to work in these events at the moment as well. And I think they found it good fun and hugely beneficial. So I think thanks to them, the staff who were probably less visible but did some sterling work, and have actually done their best to make this work in lots of ways in areas that they've looked after when these events haven't taken place before. Particularly things like the Philharmonic coming to Birmingham, yeah. Events like that. There's a lot of preparation, a lot of clearing, and of course, a lot of background legalistic type work to do as well. So thanks to them, and thanks to you and the team as well.
Steve,
last
one. You're looking for evidence. A small piece of evidence. We've noticed over the last 2 years that the U-boat exhibition in Woodside has actually gone from being in the red to being in the black, and that's simply by extra footfall. And the reason why those people have been there, we're still trying to examine, but there's more people coming to that part of the town. I can't help in my own mind not making the link between what's going on with our promotion of Hound Square and the area. People are migrating down towards there and actually taking. So it's gone from red to black, effectively saving taxpayer money. But if that starts to make even more money, that goes back into better transport system. So it's just one example like that that might indicate that the people are coming back to that area.
That's correct.
I'd just like to say a few words at the end for me. The one thing that really does stand out is of our colleagues over here, that was for every pound spent we said we get. And it's a well-organised organisation as well as local organisations that do the figures in relation to this. And we do see, and we have seen year on year, get a fantastic return on the minimum amount of money that we put in as local authority. I would say, Andrew got a long memory, but remember me sitting over there a few years back and asking the cabinet to put more money, but unfortunately I couldn't get anybody to second me. Because we realised the visitor economy is actually growing, it's growing dramatically, and it's something that we need as an authority to support. Cabinet members sit up there with a lovely smile on their face. We went to Bristol, when was it, 2 years ago?
Oh, I can't remember. 18
years ago. We went to Bristol to see how they were doing the organisation. Yeah, you remember that. We went to see how the links between the universities and local communities. And what the business owners said, what they were doing was actually allowing the students to start the businesses off, using the local authorities' establishment. But the payback was they had to guarantee so many hours working in their particular subject back to the local authority, which was benefiting everything. And they were actually, none of them at the time, they were small businesses that were just starting off with 2, 3, and then 5. Once you get to 5, you were off and you started some own businesses. And that was a regular thing that was going, and I'm really delighted to see that we're starting to move in that direction, because every one of those small, medium firms create jobs. When we looked at the reports earlier on, it's something that we are getting more jobs created, but they're not for the right type of people. So we need to do that. The recommendation is to note the progress made and to consider how the committee will inform the ongoing development. I think you've had plenty of information in relation to that already before going forward. So I'd ask all members to note that. But prior to me finishing, I want to add an extra bit of it. And I would like it minuted. Our thanks to all the staff who are doing this and helping to move forward.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
attendance.
Yeah.
So I agree.